So we took a history trip to Berlin for 3 nights, 4 days, and we took mostly year 10s, but we also took some year 11s, a couple of year 12s and 13, because they hadn't had a chance to do a school trip during the COVID years. So it was a chance for those groups to go to Berlin. And we visited a whole range of different sites in Berlin. We went to the Reichstag, we went to the Holocaust Memorial, we went to the Brandenburg Gate, the Olympic Stadium, Sachsenhausen Memorial site at the concentration camp, went to a new synagogue and the Spy Museum. So lots of things we did, yeah.
The first day we just walked around central Berlin, saw the Brandenburg Gate and walked around and saw the Soviet Memorial, and that was incredible. And then the second day we went again to the centre of Berlin and saw all the different memorials for the different people that sadly were affected during the Holocaust. So we saw the LGBTQ memorial, which was so powerful, along with the Jewish memorial, which was, I don't even know how to sum it up. It was incredible. And we also spent a lot of time just walking through the streets and seeing the difference between the west side and the east side, which is still so apparent, which is crazy after all these years.
Really enjoyed making good connections with everyone. And it was interesting to get a really good, like from an educational perspective, from the teachers as well. They were really able to help me understand Germany a lot more. And it was really interesting, really enjoyed learning about the cultural and national splits in Germany over the kind of last 100 years.
I thought it was really interesting, sort of like going out, going and do something more sort of outside the classroom, but you're still learning about things, and yeah, really fun to do.
On the Tuesday, we went to Sachsenhausen Memorial Site, so a former concentration camp. It's really important we refer to it as a memorial site, because since 1961 it has been established as the national memorial site for the ex-concentration camp.
It was really, really memorable going to the concentration camp, and then there was a really good like switch up of the mood, and we went then to the Olympic Stadium, which was really, really good, and it kind of related to our USA course a bit with Jesse Owens, so yeah, it's really good.
One of those difficult places where you can't really, it's almost too out of this world to describe, so it was, yeah, it was difficult to kind of explain the emotion, I'd say.
They get to see the places that they've learned about in the classroom, they get to see some of the documents that they've read about in the textbook in first hand. They also get to meet other experts.
I'm very much a visual learner, so being able to actually see what the textbook tells me about is really incredible. But also, I know that a lot of the year 10s say that it was really good to be able to like visualise what a textbook says.
I think it definitely helps. Like, I know that if anyone asks me a question about the trip, I can always give them a little bit of extra help or a little bit of extra insight, which would really help me with help me and help them just in general with class.
We learned a lot about Germany and the split between East and West and the Berlin Wall. We did a lot about that. It was very interesting learning about how policed everything really was. World War II as well, and the rise of Hitler. And also what was really interesting was the resistance. So whether that was school children or generals within the army as well.
Not only is it great for Nazi Germany in the Weimar years, but it's also good because it's been the historical centre of the Western world really since 1945 to 1991. So we got to explore all the bits of the Cold War, such as the Berlin Wall, which is there in many places and is in our recent history. Most of their parents will have remembered the Berlin Wall being brought down. And actually to see it and to recognise that for such a long length of time the city's been divided is really powerful.
Probably the guided tour around Berlin by the teachers. So we went to the Reichstag, the Brandenburg Gate and like several memorials. I thought it was very interesting, and because the teachers ran it, it was very related to our GCSE course. So they're all linking back to what we need to know and what we might not need to know, but it's still good to reflect on.
The teachers were so knowledgeable, and like they really brought the trip to life, and all their knowledge they brought to the trip, and asking them random questions, and it's just whatever you wanted to know about, they kind of knew about it.
Downtime, so a bit of shopping. Students managed to spend a lot of time finding random things in Germany, but they did really well. So they went, yeah, a bit of shopping, a bit of food. We were actually really impressed with the students' general susceptibility to broadening their cultural horizon and willingness and wanting to understand what was going on in Germany, so that was fantastic, and I think they took a lot away from it, more than just the history, and they went on to achieve, they actually understood about the system in Germany, which is really good.
It was really nice, especially as the only upper six. I went into it a bit nervous because I was there, like, I'm going for my academics, but also who do I have on the social side? And everyone blended so well together. So I know I spent a lot of my time with the year 12s and year 11s, and everyone got on so well. And we went bowling one night, which was so fun because all of us got so competitive for no reason.
Since getting back in the classroom, I feel like I can link things to sort of certain things that I've learned about. So if someone mentions the Reichstag, I can think like the actual building that's there and I can picture it rather than just being like, that's a random building there. And I think it's going to really help me with my course